Okay, well, here's the first cut on the new bandsaw, and I think it's only fitting that this is a cut that's going to be for my friend August, who hooked me up with the motor and the switch and the frequency drive and everything. This is going to be for the Moxon vise that's going to be on his new very super cool tools, super duper ultimate work table. So let me turn the bandsaw on. And then I'll turn the collector on, but I want you to hear how quiet this is. It's just shocking compared to what it used to be. Okay, so let me turn the collector on, and I'm going to set this board up 8-quarter wenge. Okay, what I'm getting ready to do now is to replace this cast iron foot here with this cast iron member here, and both of these bolt into the bottom of this rack and pinion mechanism with a 17 millimeter bolt. So let me just take this one off now. Well, I don't have a 17 millimeter deep well, so I'll use this 17 millimeter wrench here. Let me just go ahead and completely take this apart so I'm not fumbling with it. Leave that just a little bit loose until I get things the way I like them. Just tighten that up just a little bit too. Okay, so there's the upper guide just roughly in place. Now let's get rid of this lower one. And that just simply is just removing, loosening this bolt here on the side. And this phenolic unit comes out. And this unit just slips right in place here. OK,
Okay, like I said, I'm just going to have them just rough right now until I get the blade on there and determine where the blade's going to go. Okay, let's get the blade. Well, this blade looks a little more worn than I remembered, so it's hard to tell how much I'd actually, it's been so long since I put this on here, but you know, here's the blade I'm putting on right now. So I think that's it's probably a 10 millimeter, so it's probably 1 centimeter this way, if that. Yeah, that's what that is, 10 millimeters. So let's put this on. When this goes on, it definitely rides all the way on the rubber wheel. So I don't know how long this one will last. I'm going to be happy to buy some more blades, though, if now that I've got this new motor and everything's going to be quiet and. It still feels sharp though, man. Now, I didn't touch this one up. I'm just putting it right back on the way it had sat for a long time. Okay, let me get some tension on this. There's a little guide on the back that tells tension. So that's a 9.25 to 12.5 millimeter. So I'm right there. Don't want to break this thing. It could probably go a little tighter, but I'm not gonna. Okay, I got. I got some pretty serious issues with this. Get this out of the way. I just want to get this thing running pretty true on the. That crack in my shop floor, that's why it's rocking. Well, that doesn't look bad right there. I think I'm gonna take all this stuff away, turn the motor on for a second and really get this thing running true, and then I'll bring the guide rails up, the guide bearings up. Just go ahead and put this back on right now too. Plug in my frequency drive. right there.
I probably should have just left this off. It's going to be easier to adjust it with it off here. Okay, let me just go through the process and get this, you know, I've got in and out, I've got bearing this way, and, you know, I don't want the bearings actually touching these things. I want to leave them almost touching, but not quite. That will damage blades when you have the friction of the steel roller touching it. I mean, it's a pretty delicate dance. So let me fuss with that now.